This video describes how to set up the ServiceNow ITOM event management application using the guided setup process. ITOM guided setup steps you through the process of setting up event management, including connectors and listeners to collect event data from sources in your IT system, event rules to process those events, and alert rules, workflows, and other remediations. You'll need at least one ServiceNow mid-server in your IT system to support event management. Watch this video to learn how to set up a mid-server. To start the setup, we'll go to ITOM Guided Setup and get started. Guided Setup can help you set up several ITOM apps. For this demo, we'll go straight to Event Management. The first setup task is Event Sources and Properties. There are lots of properties related to event management. For more information, read Installed with Event Management in the product documentation. Once you've got Event Management up and running, you can update these properties anytime at Event Management, Settings, Properties. When we're done, we'll mark the step as complete and go back to Guided Setup. The next task is to define connectors to pull events from sources in our IT system. Event Management comes with connectors for a variety of event sources. We'll define an instance of one of these connectors for each source in our system. We associate the connector with the source by specifying the IP address of the source's host. For more information, read Configure a Connector Instance in the product documentation, or watch Collecting Events and Metrics in this video series. Next, we'll define listeners to receive events pushed by sources in our system. On the mid-servers, we can define web service endpoints and endpoints for SNMP traps. And on the instance, we can define actions to respond to emails from event sources. For more information, read Connectors and Listeners in the product documentation. Next, we'll define event rules to handle events received by the connectors and listeners. These event rules generate alerts based on the events. In the Event Rule Designer, we can define a filter to generate alerts for events that match certain conditions, map fields in the event to fields in the alert, set frequency thresholds to handle repeated events, and bind the alert to specific CIs. For more information, read Create Event Rules in the product documentation or watch Event Rules in this video series. Event field mappings let us set the values of specific fields in the alert based on the values of specific fields in the event. Here, for example, if the value of the MN state field in the event is 3, the value of the MN state field in the alert is set to pending. These mappings happen after the event rules run. For more information, read Create Event Field Mappings in the product documentation. Correlation rules combine related alerts into groups and define a primary alert. This helps IT personnel focus on the root cause. Here, if event management generates an alert for high CPU use, this rule defines a new group with this alert as the primary and adds to the group any alerts for high read latency or high memory use if the alerts are for the same CI or node and they occur within 24 hours after the primary. For more information, read Create an Alert Correlation Rule in the product documentation or watch Grouping Alerts in this video series. Finally, Guided Setup lets you define remediation actions to resolve issues identified by the events and alerts. First, we can create task templates to set the values of specific fields when event management creates a record. Here, when event management creates an incident, this template provides values for the state and active fields. We'll see how task templates are applied by alert action rules in a minute. For more information, read Create a Standard Change Task Template in the product documentation. Next, we can create remediation workflows. Workflows is a big topic, so we won't go into detail here. For more information, read Workflow in the product documentation or watch Creating Service Catalog Execution Plans and Workflows. Next, we'll create alert action rules to launch remediation actions based on the content of the alerts. This rule creates an incident for any alert where the severity is critical. The tabs at the bottom let us specify remedial actions to take. Remember that task template we saw earlier? This rule applies it to each incident it creates. And the workflow we saw? We could apply that or any other workflow here. For more information, read Create or Edit an Alert Action Rule in the product documentation, or watch Alert Action Rules in this video series. And finally, we can launch a remediation workflow for any particular type of CI. Here, whenever the CI class is Computer, Event Management launches the workflow we saw earlier. Alert Rules provides the same functionality as alert-based remediations, which we saw earlier. Now that we've completed these three tasks, Event Management is ready to use. And going forward, you can update any of these resources anytime by updating the corresponding list or form. In our next video, we'll look at setting up operational intelligence. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.